Welcome to my next class, dear students. In this class, I will explain to you one more question of less than type ogive curve. But this question is a little bit different. See how to solve. Let's see the question first. During the medical checkup of 35 students of a class, their weight were recorded as follows. Weight of 35 student is given here. Less than 38, there are total number of students are 0. Like this, less than 43, 5, it is given. Now keep in mind one thing: whenever is data given in the form of less than type or in the more than type, here frequency given is cumulative frequency, not frequency. Keep in mind, these frequencies are cumulative frequencies. Now what we have to do is we have to draw a less than type ogive for the given data, and we have to obtain the median weight from the graph. We have to find median from the graph and verify the result by using formula, and we have to verify also the result by using median formula. Let's start. We know the less than type ogive is drawn between upper limits and cumulative frequency distribution. Here upper limits are given as well as cumulative frequency is given. If it is data is given like this and asking you to find the less than type ogive, then you no need to find out the frequency. Here this given data is cumulative frequency only. We can directly draw the ogive curve. Let's start. This is my graph. Okay, this is a wrong line. Okay, so you draw on a graph paper, you will get the perfect answer. First we have to write this data. This data, the all are upper limits. Upper limits on x-axis. We have to write upper limits on x-axis. In the upper limits, what are the values? 38 40 42 44 46 48 50 52. These values we'll write here. First value is 38, second is 40, 42, 44, 46, 48, 50 and 52. Okay, we are starting from here. We can start like this also. Now let's see the points. First point is 38, 0. 38, 0 will come on this line only. Here only this is 38, 0. Then next point here, it is 40, 3. Here this is 40. Okay, this is 40, 3. 3 will be somewhere here. Here you will find 10 small boxes. On third small box you will have 40, 3. Then it is 42, 5. Let's plot it. 42, 5. This is 42, 5 will be in the middle, in between 0 and 10. In the middle you will find the 5. Okay, it will be here. Then it is 44, 9. Let's plot it. 44, 9. This is 44, 9. It's one box below 10. Next point is 46, 14. 46, 14. This is 46, 14. Okay, above 10, 4 boxes. 46, 14. It will be somewhere here. 46, 14. Then next point is 48, 28. 48, 28. This is 48, 28. Will be below 30. 2 boxes below 30. Okay, it will come somewhere here. Then next point is 50, 32. This is 50, 32 will be two boxes above 30. Then last point is 52, 35. Let's plot it. 52, 35. 52 here and 30 is here on this line, comma 52, 35 will be in between 30 and 40, the middle line. Okay, so now we have plot the graph between upper limits, as I said, in less than type OGIF curve. The graph is plot between upper limit and cumulative frequency distribution. The important thing to remember is whenever is data is given in the form of less than type or more than type, the frequency given here is cumulative frequency. This is very important. Okay, we can directly draw the graph if it is given like this. We no need to find the cumulative frequency. Upper limit, and this is cumulative frequency distribution. Okay, this cumulative frequency distribution we have taken in the difference of 10. Now let's draw the graph, and as I said in my previous classes also, the graph has to be plotted by free hand, not by a scale. Let's join these points. Okay, first question here, draw a less than type OGIF. That will complete when we draw it. This we have done, it is over. The first question is over. Draw a less than type OGIF. Also keep in mind, sometime this data will be given and only this question will be given. Okay, less than type data, less than type OGIF for the given data. Up to here only question will be given. If it is given up to here, no need to find the remaining two. Remaining two things we have to find now. Then next question here is, okay, hence obtain the median weight from the graph. We have to find the median weight from the graph. How we find median? To find the median, first what we used to do is the total number of frequencies divided by 2. N by 2 we used to find. If you see my previous classes, in that I have explained how to find median. Okay, in finding median, first we have find total number of frequencies divided by 2. The same thing we have to do here. 35 divided by 2, total frequencies are 35 divided by 2 will give you 17.5. now here n by 2 is 17.5. this we have to mark on the y-axis. We have to mark on the y-axis 17.5. this is 10. The 15 will come in the middle, then one box above will be 16, above one 17, then in between 17 and 18 you will find 17.5. okay, somewhere here if you draw on a graph paper you will get a perfect answer, because I am graph paper is not available with me, so that's why I'm drawing like this. Now let's see what to do. This is 17.5, first we have to mark, and with the help of a scale just we need to draw a line up to the less than type OGIF curve. See how we have drawn up to here. Okay, then wherever it touches, from that point come down and touch on the y-axis. It touching here, we are coming down, it will be here somewhere. Okay, so this is 46 and in the middle it will be 47, so it is coming in between 46 and 47. This is 46, this is 47, 48. So if it is coming in between 46 and 47, so median from the graph, is 46.5. It is coming 46.5. Okay, so second question is over. Total three questions are there. First question is draw less than type OG for the given data. This is the first one we have done, less than OGIF. And the second one, obtain the median weight from the graph that we have. There are three question students here. You see the draw less than type OGIF for the given data. We have drawn less than type OGIF for the given data. For this data, we have drawn less than type OGIF curve. Then the second question is obtain the median weight from the graph, and we have done this one. We have find the median from the graph, that is 46.5, and I have shown you how to find it. Now the third question is verify the result by using formula. This 46.5, we have to check it is correct or not by using formula. Okay, let's do it. First we have to convert this less than type data into group data. See how to find it. Here you can see the first class interval, we can write like this, 36 to 38. We are converting less than type data into group data. The difference between these two values is 2, that's why we are writing 36 to 38. Then next will come 38 to 40. Like with the difference of 2, we can continue it after writing first one. 38 to 40, 40 to 42, 42 to 44. We have to write all this value. We converted this less than type data into group data. Now I'm writing here first cumulative frequency. This is the cumulative frequency. It is given in the question. The cumulative frequency is 0, 3, 5, 9, 14, 28, 32, 35. Now, to find the median, we need frequency. Let's see how to find the frequencies. The first one will be as it is. To find the second one, we have to subtract the second and first. Okay, first from second, we have to subtract. Like this, 3 minus 0 will give you 3. Then to get the third one, this third one minus second one. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. Then to get the fourth one, we have to subtract this value and this value. 9 minus 5 is equal to 4. Then for the next, 14 minus 9 is equal to 5. Then 28 minus 14 is equal to 14. Then 32 minus 28 is equal to 4. And 35 minus 32 is equal to 3. These are the frequencies, okay? 0, 3, 2, 4, these are the frequencies. Now let's verify the result by using formula. As we know, to find the median by using formula, first we have to find n by 2. And the value of n by 2 is 17.5. And here we have to see the which value in the cumulative frequency is nearest and greater than the value of n by 2. The value which is nearest and greater than n by 2 is 28. This is the nearest and greater than the value of n by 2. The value of n by 2 is 17.5. 20 is the nearest and the greater than 17.5. So based on this this value, we'll decide this one as our median class. So I'll write here median class is 46 to 48. Then this one will be our frequency, and this is not our commutative frequency, this is our commutative frequency. I already explained, you can see in the explanation of how to find the median. Now let's write all the values. F is 14 and CF is also 14 and lower limit is 46. Okay, then H also we should know, H is the difference between the class interval, that is 2. Let's write the formula of median. Median is equal to L plus N by 2 minus CF divided by F into H. Let's substitute the values. L is 46 plus N by 2 is how much? 17.5, we found already. Minus CF is how much? 14. Divided by frequency is also 14 into H is 2. This is 2 ones are 2 sevens are, we can cancel it. 46 plus now 17.5 minus 14 is how much? 3.5 divided by 7. Now this is 3.5 ones are, 3.5 twos are, we can cancel. 46 plus 1 by 2 is how much? 0.5. When you add 46 and 0.5, it will be 46.5. This is median. Now let's see from the graph what we got. We got from the graph 46.5 here. And when we verify, we also got the same answer, 46.5. It means the answer from the graph what we got is correct. Sometime the verification is asked and sometime you will not ask the verification. If verification is asked in the question, you have to verify. Otherwise, you no need to verify the result. Keep in mind. I hope you understood how to find less than type OGF and how to find median from the graph and how to verify the result. Thank you for watching my video, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you again. See you in the next class.